think this is a great challenge for us. You know, to be to go head to head against some of these teams that are fighting for playoff berth down the stretch in September is a great experience. I think it shows the character and the fight and fire that our guys have right now, and the way that we're playing. You know, Cozart set the tone kind of effectively wild early, got his cut fastball going, and utilized his breaking pitch very well, and then turned it over to the bullpen that just did a tremendous job in some tough situations, and they were able to get big outs, only gave up one unearned run. So thought overall it was a very well played and crisp ball game. We had two productive outs that turned into runs for us with Ozo's ground ball, and then with the fly ball out there. So, you know, I thought overall the guys played a very crisp and clean ball game, and it's good to see. It's good to see us play these teams that are trying to get in, that are fighting to get in. It's a great experience for our young guys especially. And, you know, some of the guys in the bullpen are getting placed in some tough spots, and they're responding in a good way. But I thought that what Cozart was able to do for five, tremendous job, and set a very good tone.
Cozart, are you starting to see the same guy from last year?
Yeah, he is. He's got a natural cut action on his fastball, and it's a huge pitch for him. And for him to be able to pitch that aggressive, like I said, kind of effectively wild early, settled into a good rhythm there, got his tempo going, and you know, got us through five in a way that he needed to do. He's that attack mentality, and he did that tonight.
You talked about Realmuto before the game, and he starts the, you know, the decisive rally again with the double.
Yeah, it was good. He gets the double, Itchy gets the bunt down, and then with you know, Miggy battled, and that was a tremendous at bat to be able to get the sack fly. And I thought he, the way he approached that, you know, fouling off some pitches, and was able to get to that spot to where he could get a pitch up and drive it to the outfield. And in JT's speed, he's back to tag and scores really pretty easy on that. And it's just a weapon to have, a catcher that has that type of athleticism and that foot speed.
DJ, when's the last time you saw a catcher like that with that kind of speed? Anybody come to mind?
Wow. You probably got maybe a Biggio before he went to second base, you know, that kind of speed. There are very few guys that have that component where they, you know, he can steal a base, he goes first to third. You saw the inside of the park the other day, and then the ability to go back and tag right there on a medium depth fly ball and score a run. It's a tremendous weapon to have on the bases, and it allows us to put the game in motion, not be afraid to start him at any time and any count over there when he's at first base.
Keith Cookman and Dunner, even getting Harper, I mean, not the easiest guy, but Jared got him a couple of times, and Dunn, just you guys.
Yeah, I mean, the guys having an MVP type season, he and Dunn have a history. I mean, you look up their numbers and how many times they face one another. And in that situation, it was the right time for Dunn to come in, and he made the quality pitches that he needed to make. And you know, between he and BMO there to split that seventh inning the way they did and get the three outs between them, and then, you know, bringing Ellington there in the eighth inning, man, he threw the ball absolutely outstanding, and then AJ comes on to get number 26. So the bullpen has continued to step up in such a huge way and make key pitches in key situations. But there was really none bigger than Dunn facing Harper there in the seventh inning.